we are now going to calculate a one-way chi-square goodness of fit test in JASP. For this example, we are going to assume that the observed values in one group, the pigs, do not differ from the values in a comparison population, the bears, or that there is no difference between the groups. This is the pig and bear chi-square. A house inspector knows that families of three bears choose building materials in a certain pattern. Out of 70 houses built by bear families, 30 were brick and mortar, 20 were sticks, and 20 were straw. The house inspector then randomly samples building permits pulled by 70 little pigs who were building houses to determine whether a pattern exists in the materials that the little pigs chose for housing construction. Our research question is, do the pig and bear building permit patterns differ significantly? We know the bear's pattern. Is the pig's pattern different? In the previous video, we created the entire dataset from scratch using Excel. If you still have that dataset, use that. If you do not, here is how to create it. There were three building materials used for housing construction, so we will call this first variable materials. And now we can list the three types of materials: straw, sticks, or brick and mortar. JASP will allow us to import these labels and use them as variable names. The second variable we will need is the number of permits. We will call it permits. The building inspector consults his notes and reports that the values for each type of building material are 16, 21, and 33. So what we have is a scale variable, the counts for the number of permits, and a nominal variable, or factor, which is the type of permits. We need to save this dataset to the desktop as a CSV. Call it building permits. Let's check the desktop. There it is. Now we are ready to open JASP. Our first step will be to import the dataset that we just created. We start with the main menu icon and select Open, Computer, Desktop, and then select BuildingPermits.csv. Click Open. We see that material is a nominal text variable, what SPSS calls a string variable. Notice the small a on the icon in the blue ball. Permits is intended to be a scale variable. And with this, we are ready to do our chi-square test. There are several options for how to do a chi-square test in JASP, all of them in the Frequencies menu. But with the way that we have entered our data, we will use the Multinomial Test. Go to Frequencies, Multinomial Tests. Now this may be a little confusing if you're looking for independent and dependent variables. But remember that JASP is built on the R platform, and JASP is using that language. So the factor refers to our groups. What are our groups? The groups are the types of materials. Notice the shaded icons that remind us only nominal and ordinal variables can go here. What would be our counts? We can tell from the shaded icons that this must be a scale variable. Remember that our data are totals, so we want JASP to weight each group or type of building material by the counts, which are the number of permits issued for each type of building material. Already we see some results. But these are not the results that you are looking for. We still need to specify our expected values. The expected values are the comparison values that we learned from the bears. To see this more clearly, click on Descriptives. These results are based on test values that assume equal proportions. Each type of building material was chosen equally. But we have expected proportions that were derived from the bears. For each type of building material, enter the number appropriate to it. 30 for brick and mortar, 20 for sticks, and 20 for straw. Look at the table for descriptives. Here we see the observed values that we entered and the expected values, which are the comparison values for the comparison group. Notice that none of the cells have expected frequencies less than 5. That is good news, and it meets the assumptions for the chi-square test. Notice, too, that you can ask JASP to display proportions instead of counts. That could be useful if the number of expected values was a different number than 70. Let's say you had 300 comparison values from the bears for your 70 observations from the pigs. You could still use the proportions from the bears and get the same chi-square results. We can also get a nice descriptive plot right here. If you want the 95% confidence intervals, you can ask for them here. Those intervals are already included in our descriptive plot in the form of bars. Returning to the test statistics, we see that our chi-square value is 1.15. And the probability of getting that chi-square, if the null hypothesis is true, is 0.563, which is greater than 0.05. So these observed data from the three little pigs are not statistically significantly different than the expected values from the bears. There is no difference in the pattern of choices of the building materials. The pigs and the bears choose house building materials in essentially the same ratio. And remember that if you ever need information about what each of these options does, you can click on the blue eye to show info for analysis. The measure of effect size for a chi-square is called Kramer's V. I cover Kramer's V in detail in another video about effect size for chi-square. It is actually a measure of association. JASP will calculate this for you if you do your chi-square using the option Frequencies Contingency Table. You see here that we have the option for phi in Kramer's V. I'm sure that this functionality will eventually be added to the multinomial tests. But until then, here is how you calculate it yourself. The formula for Kramer's V is the square root of the chi-square divided by n times t, where n is your sample size and t is the smaller of either r-1 or c-1, where r is the number of rows and c is the number of columns. The smallest value that t can assume is 1. Calculate the Kramer's V by plugging in the values from our test. We already know our chi-square value, and our sample size was 70. We had three types of building materials, or three rows, but essentially we only had the two columns, so the smaller of those two options would be 2 minus 1. Divide the chi-square by 70, and take the square root. You get a Kramer's V measure of association of 0.13. And here is a sample APA-style write-up for the one-way chi-square goodness of fit test. We used chi-square to compare the pattern of porcine and ursine building permits. We concluded the pattern of permits pulled by the pigs did not differ statistically significantly from the pattern of permits pulled by the bears. the bears, know that building with brick and mortar is smart. And the pigs are at least as smart as the average bear. And that is how we calculate a one-way chi-square goodness of fit test in JASP.